Hello YouTube, and welcome to another review from me, Steve. And today, we're not going to be talking about a vacuum cleaner, which makes a change for me, as I normally collect vacuum cleaners, but this review is going to be about my carpet washer, or my ex-carpet washer, as I should say now, because I've just replaced it, and more about that later. But this is what I've been using since 2006. I bought it 8 years ago, and it's been used every year, sometimes more than once a year. In fact, it's been used quite a bit, because I've had pets in the past, and had a dog, and I've got a cat now. And this machine, it's had a fair bit of use over the years. But unfortunately, it's now broken. So I had to go and buy another one. So basically, this is the Vax Rapide Deluxe. Its model number is the V-026. And I bought it in 2006. And I think I had this one from Argos. Although I'm not quite sure, I can't quite remember now where I had it from, but I think it was from Argos. It wasn't the top of the range at the time. It was a sort of a mid-model in the range. There were better ones available, but as I don't particularly have a very large house, and I only really wanted it to shampoo the carpets downstairs where the pets go, then I thought this one would suffice. And for the first few years, it's been quite a good little machine. So, what do we get on the Vax Rapide Deluxe? As you can see here, it has the traditional design for a carpet washer, which it has a solution tank here on the handle, and it has the pickup tank down here. On the back, this model was the one that came with the hose and the attached tool for doing upholstery. And indeed, I have used it to try and clean upholstery, but as you can see from my sofas now, they are looking rather soiled again, because it didn't particularly do a very good job. All it used to do was soak the sofa and didn't really get the dirt out, so I decided it was better for use on carpets than on upholstery. Maybe it's just my sofas, because I decided to have pets with a beige suite, but there we go, that's one of the downfalls about having light coloured furniture. It shows off the dirt. But then again, you see, this suite is that's 8 years old as well, so not new. So we got the cable on the back here. Just unwrap this. Now, this cable was perfectly sufficient for the what I wanted it to do, which was the front room there and in here, and also to do the stair carpets with the hose. And I think this was probably, oh, I don't know, I'll have to stretch it out. I don't know what length this cable is on here. Yeah, it's longer than 6 metres. I'd say it's probably about eight metre cable, maybe more. But then again, when you're only using these on a less frequent basis than a vacuum cleaner, you don't really bother to that much about cable length. You'd always use an extension if it was too short. So, that was the handle, the cable rather. Exits the machine here, and when it's in use, you have a little cable clip there, but it's alright coming from here. As I said on the vacuum cleaners, I don't like it when they come out right down the bottom. Now you add, on this one, a hose with a little trigger handle there for spraying the solution out, and you have the nozzle. The upholstery nozzle there. It's an okay nozzle. If we just unclip this, like so. Again, everything on this actually clips into place securely, so the hose wasn't forever falling off the machine as you were using it. So yeah, the hose did. It fitted on very, very nicely and securely onto the back. Now this machine's absolutely filthy on the back of here, because as I say, it's had use. I've used it, and I've never really bothered about cleaning it up, because my love's with vacuum cleaners really, not with carpet washers. This was solely used for a functional purpose to clean carpets with. It's had no other love, no other attention, other than the maintenance that you're supposed to do with them. That was the hose you got. Good length hose there. Solution pipe here. Used to run up the middle of the hose. And your tool would fit on the end of the hose, like that. So you'll be able to go along your furnace by pressing the trigger in, pull it back. Like so. In fact, there's still water in there from when we used it last time. That's blimey. Never seem to dry out, do they? Okay. Now that would plug in to the machine. Now, on a Bissell machine, they have what they call ready tools, which aren't always ready for use, but on this machine, they weren't. You had to sort them out and you had to plumb them in when you needed them. So, again, this was the part here. You had to plug into the top of the machine by removing that, like so. And what that would do, that would divert the suction from the nozzle here, for the carpet nozzle, through this pipe here. And then the hose would plug in to there, like so. Then what you'd have to do is you'd have to put this solution tube onto the side here, because this was a pumped system on this machine, it wasn't gravity fed. And that would click onto there, like so. And then it would be in tools mode. So that would then be at the control of this valve here. And as you press that button, it would spray the solution out of the bottom, up to where the nozzle is here, in a fan shape. And it would equally wet the upholstery. And it would get some dirt out, but it wouldn't get the really heavy stains out. And when I had my dog, he used to rub along the bottoms of the sofa, and consequently, especially on that chair there, which you can't see on the camera, it got really black. So I tried cleaning it with this, but it just wouldn't have it. It wouldn't remove all the black stains. And again, you can see it along the front of here. That's like when people have been sitting on the sofa, the dye has come out of jeans and dark trousers, and mark the fabric on there, and no amount of washing that would get that out. I even put those covers to the washing machine and it wouldn't get it out. So, you know, that's permanently stained. So think about it when you've got light coloured furniture with dark coloured clothes. It can cause a lot of damage. So, it was good for doing the stairs. I mean, this would get a fair few stairs. And then when you needed to get high, you'd have to take the machine up to the top of the stairs and then clean from the top down. But that's what we used a stair tool. Okay. So then the tools would disconnect. I've now got to wrap this all around the machine again now, because I can't edit these videos. You'll just have to bear with me while I do it. So that pulls out. Unclips. This would fit back in here. What I liked about this is that everywhere had its place on the back of the machine. It was a well thought out machine, this was. I was very, very pleased with this machine for the time I had it. Now, unfortunately, it did develop the problem with the water control valve on this machine. From this trigger on the handle here, what it did is a push rod cable that come down the back here into the bottom where the pump was. And what was happening with it, and this happened quite a couple of years ago, and I've put up with it since then. You know, I've had to learn to use it with the faulty valve. Is that when you're pulling that trigger, it was always releasing the solution, even when the trigger was let go. So as soon as you turned it on, sometimes when you first started it, it would be all right. And you pull that, and then it would work properly. But then after a short period of time, as soon as you release that handle, and release that trigger, it would still keep on spewing the solution out. So basically, I'd have to keep using it as quick as I could, pulling it backwards and forwards over the carpet, because it would never stop spraying out the solution until the tank was empty. Now, I had it to pieces. I took the bottom apart to find out why that was happening. And I took the valve out in the bottom, and I cleaned it all out. And I put it back together again, and it worked for a little while, and then it started doing it again. So in the end, I just got fed up of it, and I bought another one. But aside from that problem, it has been a very good machine, and I've been quite impressed with it. But as it started doing that problem after about 4 years, I thought, well, you know, I can't, there's not under guarantee anymore, there's nothing else I can do about it really other than buying a new one. But I thought, well, it's only 4 years old and it doesn't get used that much. So I soldier on with it until something else better comes along. And when I saw a particular review on YouTube from another member whose username we shall say is Pneumatic Vacuum, and also I saw the same machine, well, a similar machine, done by Roger on one of his reviews, and I thought it was really good. So more about that in a little bit. I'll show you what I replaced this with in a little bit. So that goes back in there. Our hose goes back in here, winds around the top, where does it go? And the bottom, over the top, and then clicks down onto there. So that was a nice, neat and tidy way of storing. Now where did this go? I'm just trying to think now. Oh yeah, I think this clips up here to keep it out of the way. Either there or in here. Whichever way, keep it all out of the way, like so. So all in all, it was a very compact machine. In terms of other carpet washers on the market at the time, this was actually very lightweight. You know, you can pick that up very, very easily. It had the foot release pedal here, reclining it, like so. Now, with the solution tank being down the bottom of here, it would be quite a low centre of gravity. So you wouldn't, you know, unlike some of the newer Vax ones, where the solution tank's further up the handle here, which I think is on the, is it the Dual V, which Roger did a demonstration of, where on that one you had the dirty water tank at the bottom and then the clean water tank at the top. I'd imagine that would have been far more heavy when you were pulling it back, having that full container at the top of the handle. But this, a lot easier to use being at the bottom. This was easy to remove. Press that button, your tank had come off. It held what I think was 3 litres. I don't know, it doesn't say what the capacity is, but I'm sure this was 3 litres on here. And you take your cap off there. Now, you put your solution in there to measure it out. Now this was the solution that I used to use in that machine. This is one of the spare bottles I had left. When I bought the machine all those years ago, I bought 2 big boxes of 6 of those because they were going in B&Q at a bargain price, and they've lasted me all these years. So one thing I do find about carpet cleaning machines is the price of the solution is absolutely scandalous. It really is disgracefully expensive. I mean, when you look in the Argos catalogue now at these machines and you look how much they want for the solution for them, this is only a very small bottle. This is 750 millilitres. What you find now is they supply them in 1.5 litre bottles and they're nearly 20 quid. And it doesn't last very long either. You need to use a fair bit of solution in the tank each time. With this, you had to put in that one tank there 3 full caps in there. And I don't know how many millilitres were in one single cap here. I think it was, I don't know whether it's graduated on the side of here. I don't know how many millilitres one of those would hold. They didn't tell you. No. All they said was basically, they said on the back here, 3 capfuls of Vax AAA solution per full tank are required. Only use Vax AAA solution in this machine. Okay. So that was what I always used, it Vax AAA cleaning solution. So the fact that that valve broke, I always used the right type of solution here. I didn't use anything else. It was all done to the manufacturer's specification. And that water control valve went faulty. So So you fill your 3 litres of water up there, warm water, 40 degrees, or a little bit hotter maybe. Hotter water is better on a carpet because it tends to melt the grease, especially if you've got pets. When I used to have my dog, it used to roll around all over the carpet and leave dirty marks and greasy marks, because as you know, pets have greasy coats, especially short-haired dogs. And that's why my carpet now has got so many dark covered patches on it. Again, I decided to have a beige coloured carpet in 2006 when I did this room up, and I've really paid for it over the years because this carpet has been so demanding on trying to keep it clean that I would never have this colour carpet again, ever. Or I'd never have this coloured suite again ever either, because it shows every mark. So, you put your solution in there, 3 capfuls of that, warm water in there, you come back to the machine in the bottom here. You can see the valve there, the bottom of the machine. That's quite dirty. As I say, it did get used. See the cable there running down the back. And that would slot back in there, click securely into place. I never had a problem with that falling off, ever. It all went together nicely. Put that to one side. So that would be then fully charged up. Now this was the solution collection tank down the bottom here. What you do, this tank would hold less than what that held. So, here comes the cat. There she goes, off out. My pussy there loves getting cat hairs all over the furniture. Gives me an excuse to have to vacuum clean. So, this here, you push that lever and you pull it out like so. Traditional type there. And that would reveal, in the bottom, you would have a very, very, very sparse looking brush roll. And this is what it would use to agitate the pile. And to be quite honest, it was a complete waste of time, because the brushes on there are so soft, they wouldn't really have done a great deal. Wouldn't have done a great deal at all. But it was a feature of the machine, and it was also a feature that you could turn on or off as well. Because it had its own separate little motor in here that drove this brush roll. Unlike more other cleaners, which the brush roll's driven off the main motor, like on a vacuum cleaner, this did have its own brush roll switch. So you didn't have to have that running if you didn't want to. Belt driven. I never had to replace the belt in it, ever. It was easy to replace the belt on there if you did need to do it, but I never needed to change it all the time I used this machine. This is the tank. This is absolutely filthy, as I say. It got really, really heavily used, this machine, over the years. You can see there you've got your extraction along the front. This is where your hose goes in here, for the tools. What you do to empty it, you lift this back section off here, like that. And every single time, the filter would always come off and end up in the bottom in the tank there. That's a replacement, because what happened with these, over time, is they would split down there. And I had to buy a new one of those. Inside there you've got your float valve, which basically, as it filled up with dirty water, that would rise up, and if it got too full, it would completely rise to the top and block off the suction, and you'd hear the motor note change, and then you'd know that it needed emptying. Now that was supposed to fit on top of there, and that was basically to stop all the fuzz and all the dirt and all the cat hairs and everything and pet hairs and various other bits of carpet fluff from getting drawn through into the motor fan. Now, water would get sucked through there and it would go into the motor, but all that happened was that it just threw it out the bottom. Never have I had a problem with the motor on that machine, the suction motor. Never once. All the water that's gone through there and been chucked out the bottom, it's never caused a problem. So that is where your dirty water would be collected inside there. It didn't hold, as I say, the same amount as what the clean water tank held. because what you'd find is when it got to a certain amount of water in here, as you were moving it backwards and forwards, that float would bob up and down, and eventually it would block the suction off. So you'd have to go and empty this. You take it to the sink, tip it out, put that back in the top, bring it back to the machine, locate the front under there, push it down, and then the handle clicks into the retainer there and holds that nice and securely, just like so. And that was basically how the machine worked. What else can I say about it? That's it really. I've explained the basics of it. Dirty water tank, clean water tank, how you emptied it, features it's got. And I'm not going to be doing a demo on it. I won't be doing a demo on the new one either, because I've only just had that one. But as I say, I used to use still these two carpets, this one in here and that one over there in that side of the room. I would get through 3 to 4 tankfuls of that to do this size of room. And this is a two bedroom, two up, two down, terraced house. It's been a modified house. There used to be a staircase down the middle of here. It was two separate rooms, but it was knocked through at some time 20 odd years ago. So basically, to do a two bedroom terrace, the two rooms downstairs, I used 4 tanks of that. So it used about 12 litres of solution of cleaning water. So this, it would last a reasonable amount of time, but you couldn't go silly on it. You know, you had to, I would push it forwards, pull it back, and then the same again on each stroke, all the way across the carpet there. Then I'd have to change tank, put some more water in to do this middle section around here. And then I'd have to change the tank again, put some more in, and then go and do that side of the room. And then I'd have to fill the tank again to go and do up the stairs. So, yes, it used about 4. And then it took a fair amount of time to dry as well. That's one thing I did notice about this machine. The carpets were left fairly wet afterwards. And it was always best, if you were going to clean the carpets, to do it in the summer. Because I tried doing it in the winter once, and all that happened for days afterwards was the condensation was all over the windows. The carpet took ages to dry. And in the end, it started to smell. So I had to do it again. You know, it just wasn't a very good idea to do it in the winter. So, as a carpet washer, it was all right. It would remove an awful lot of dirt from the carpets. But what it wouldn't do, it wouldn't remove deep stains. Anything like oil-based, you know, if I was working on the car outside and I came in with my dirty shoes on and I got grease on the carpet or anything like that, it was a devil to get that out. And this wouldn't do it. But you would see, when you tipped all the water away, just how much dirt it did get out. So it was reasonably effective, but it wasn't 100% effective using that solution. So, in terms of giving it a rating, the fact that I use this since 2006, right up to now, I mean, this has been the only carpet washer I've ever had for this house, I would give this machine a fairly good rating. I'd give it about a 7 out of 10, possibly an 8, but it was let down because the water control valve went faulty. What it means is that, I could carry on using it, but I'd have to be aware that every time I was moving it backwards and forwards, it was always dispensing solution onto the carpet. So what I'd have to do is do the room, okay, and then, after the solution had all gone out of the tank, go back over it again several times to suck it all up afterwards. I couldn't use it in the conventional way that you're supposed to use one of these, and maybe this is why my carpet looks so dreadful now. Of course, I probably had far too much solution left in the carpets after I'd finished, because it was faulty. And more modern machines as well. Some of them you can put a rinse in as well. Although it says that you shouldn't have to do a rinse on the carpet after you've finished with it, but it remains to be seen. So there we go. I'm not going to bother wrapping that round on the video there. The question is, what did I replace it with? What did I buy to replace that Vax with? that is what I bought to replace the Vax with. That is a Bissell Clean View Power Brush. And having seen a couple of videos that were done on YouTube by two of the most prolific vacuum cleaner reviewers. Now, Roger had one of these, but it was slightly different colour. It was like a brownie coloured colour. He did a review of that on his channel some time ago. And Pneumatic Vacuum did a review of one that was higher up in the range than this, which was the Pro Heat version, but I decided I didn't really need Pro Heat. And I didn't really... What put me off the Vax was that Roger did a review of the Dual V, the Vax carpet washer. And Roger had a lot of problems with it. He had problems with the pulley inside the head melting. And when I saw that, that put me off Vax. I thought, I'm not going to buy another Vax carpet washer after seeing that. Now, he subsequently did other videos of other Vax machines afterwards, but having seen that Dual V, that really did put me off. So, I decided to try Bissell this time instead. And more about this one, because I shall be doing a review on... I shall be doing a first look. Right after I finish this video, I will have a dedicated first look for this machine here. So I'll just put this over here. I won't be doing an unboxing video. The machine is already out of the box. It's assembled over the other side of the room there. So I'll be bringing that in. I'll do a separate first look at that. But for now, this is the power, you see, of YouTube and YouTube videos. It's that users of these machines put their views forward, and it only takes one bad review, like Roger did with that Dual V, that has put me off buying these, and I will not buy another Vax. I was pretty appalled when I saw what happened to him with that machine. Now, okay, Vax did sort it out for him. They sent him another machine. But that shouldn't be happening. And the fact that this broke as well, that didn't really help. I've had problems with a lot of Vax machines in the past, with vacuum cleaners, with the carpet washer here. Whilst they are, you know, that they try and have good features on, Vaxes are not the best in terms of reliability and build quality. So anyway, that will be the last time this gets shown, because I'd imagine I'll be taking this to the tip. I don't want to be keeping it because it's no good anymore. I wouldn't be selling it to anybody else because it's not working properly. So, it'll be going to the great recycling yard in the sky. And next time I go to the recycling site, this will be going. So, from me, it's goodbye from me. And it's goodbye from the Rapide Deluxe. Until next time.